see how it looks? Did you walk past and actually look at it? All right. And so the side, not as much of it was captured as I wanted. This is the angle, whatever. The side, a slow and steady thing. My general goal is mo. Let whatever the clippings mulch back into the ground. Then we have more organic matter in the soil and we can grow more things. And at some point I would like to get another bag once like the rainy season really picks up of grass seed and so again overseed if you will. And next season have more, because I don't actually know where that grass came from. I don't think we even had that much grass, and I know I sowed, and sure, maybe some of it blew in the wind, but it's just really thick in some patches, which is great. But I want thick everywhere, right? There's a neighbor who at first I'm like, this what are you doing? Because the house is low to the ground, everything looks low to the ground, looks like, is there a wasp under the stairs? There is. Looks like if it rains it's gonna flood in. And it's just grass. But now that I'm a lawn care person, right, I see the vision. They said, we just want the sand firm. And so what they've done, similar to what I've done here, is, you know, the house on a plot of land, an area around the plot of land, including a drive area, has been mowed. Everything else has been just left. It's like, it's, why not? I should theoretically really focus on this front, because the idea is, you know, minimize things that are hiding in the tall grass. And every time I mow that, it's like a couple of roaches, whatever. There are roaches, you know, North Carolina roaches don't seem to really care to go in houses. It's great. But also don't necessarily want to move their house so they think that they can go inside. But, you know, and then there's bugs and whatever that fly. I know rabbits have been seen. Even the dogs like to go through, which is bad because there's like birds that they could stick them. So anyway, I gotta focus on that. But everything is piece by piece, right? You see the brown area. That's really just weedage that I decided not to pull up because pulling up is really too easy to do. But then it's like there's something holding the sand. Let me just bend and break the weedage to, again, mulches in. And I think even other places on the side where I've gone and I've cleared out things by hand, more grass has come up. It's like, oh, there's space for me now. Love this for me. So I want more grass here. I gotta figure out, I think most of what's coming up is maybe fescue right now. I think. So maybe it's more Bermuda grass I need, but also Bermuda grass is it's so much work to keep it out of the front. Which, had I thought about it, really, I probably should have put a fraction of sheet mulch initially. Well, that chance is gone, right? Unless I decide to rip everything out, and not even rip everything out, just let it be. I lose all my bulbs, because I don't know where the Dutch iris are. I have perennials in there that are going to be coming back, so I don't think I'm going to do that. So at this point, really just weeding and overcrowding with desired plants. Anyway, let me see. Oh, I thought it was more. Oh, you do see. I got the band around the abdomen at the top of the front. I don't know what you could see back there. Oh, it's pretty much the whole back. How fun. Anyway, thanks for watching. Bye. Time for pictures.